Alright, let's hit up this Grand Prix. I'm bad. I am bad. Bad at a lot of things, but good at this game. Time to do a little booty shake. Oh, where's this race at? Woo!
Hey, Boy Scout.
What up, Sheriff? Yo, shut up, chick. I'm actually gonna assault you. Ornament Valid GP, that's what we're looking for. I'm actually gonna commit assault.
And we're here at the start of race number 3 of the Radiator Springs Grand Prix with Vince, who came all the way out here from Queens? Is that right?
Yeah.
Hi, Ma!
And why Radiator Springs? Did you come all the way out here to race against Lightning McQueen?
No. We know that guy, but, you know, actually, we came out to, train with Chick, you know, yeah. We figured if he wants to be the best, you know, he's got to train with, like, a real professional racer, you know? Someone who could win a lot. And yeah.
Dude. L interview. Alright, muscle car versus the whatever I am. Here we go. Boost it up from the start. So there's 2 laps on this one. Cool. I don't know if I could take that shortcut. It's a little bit of a weird one there. Alright, it's this one. The one with the weird start right there. Alright. So far, so good, though. Yeah, so far, so good. Woo, hit that slide. You know who it is. Alright. That lead is alright. Honestly, for the way I'm racing, I thought I'd have a bigger lead than that. I feel like I haven't screwed up this track all that often. Then maybe the first little turn, I definitely hit the wall on that one. Yeah, this hasn't been a bad one so far. Ooh, got a weird little bump right there. Alright, I'm gonna lose a lot of my lead here. Oh, that's unfortunate. Alright, well, I don't know what happened there, but that was pretty bad. Okay, that was kind of bad. But we're alright. We'll just have to catch up. Yeah, definitely screwed my lead right there pretty big. It almost would have been more useful to run off the track in that instance. The way I did it, it just screwed me up in every sense. Maybe I'll just jump off the track next time. Alright. Started off good, ended it somewhat disastrously. But we're alright. I'm really using my boost and saving my screw ups here, but if I could maybe just not screw up and then just use my boosts to get a lead, that would be cool too. Alright. First lap. So we managed to stay in first. Theoretically, if we don't make that big screw up that we did is right there, we should be able to get an even bigger lead here.
One for the faint.
Alright. And second lead, it's pretty good, pretty good. Just keep doing good here. This one always screws me up. And things won't be any different on this one. Man. I'll go rough. I'm gonna blame that one on my itchy nose, though. That one was definitely the itchy nose. Now we got 15 seconds, though, to play with. Which is not bad at all. I do have to remember, in the end, this is technically a children's game. Alright, I almost did the exact same mistake again. Luckily, this time, I kind of boinked off the side and ended up being fine, but... That was almost dangerous again. I almost messed it up. Cue eagle noises. America! Bro, what track are you talking about, bro? Alright, 17 lead. No idea how, considering it's been a pretty trash race on my part, but hey. I'll never not take it. You hand me a win on a silver platter, we take those. I'm not one to complain about something like that. Ka-chow. Alright, give me that W. Alright, I was right. You literally teleported me to the exact same place. What? What was the point of any of that, huh? Alright, give me the win. No, you're bad. Alright, 25 second lead. We take those. Ch-ch-ch-chow. Alright. We're going to the Piston Cup now. Right? Piston Cup V2. Me versus Chick for all the marbles, even though Chick horrendously has lost every single race thus far. Ka-chow. That's why I'm like going as fast as I can even towards this. Now we'll just hit that. Alright, where are we at? Los Angeles International Speedway. The last race of this. Well, it's not the last thing in the game. Like, we could still finish all the Tomator missions and the dock missions, but.
This is it, Mac. Yeah. Hey, what's the matter?
You know, end of the season and all. I'm just gonna miss this, that's all.
Ah, come on, Mac. You know that a champion has to go back the following season to defend his trophy, right? You and I got plenty more road to travel, partner.
It's true. Why is Mac acting like this is the last race we'll ever have? It's the last race we'll have in this game, probably, but in the digital fiction world, McQueen over here is going to be racing up until he's old. Cue into movie 3. One of the greatest masterpieces made ever. I guess we haven't talked about the movies at all. As far as my opinion, if you guys care in the slightest, number 1 is a masterpiece. Number 2 is horrendous, and we don't talk about it. Number 3 is another absolute masterpiece. So, I just watch 1 and 3. I don't bother with 2. All right, finishing the top 3, first place. All right, this is the big one. Let's do this. Right, here we go. Oh, of course, I get caught on the banana car in the first second.
You know, he always runs well at this track.
Yeah, the Piston Cup track.
He's definitely in the zone. Just look at his determination.
All right, we're not doing terrible.
Well, they say lightning never strikes twice, but those cars out there will tell you different.
Is this out of track? Okay, that is out of track for some stupid reason. You mind letting me through, bud? You mind letting me through? I got 12 reps. Alright, this is a bad place to be. Let me through.
Well, they say lightning never strikes twice, but those cars out there will tell you different.
Yup.
Here comes Lightning McQueen. Just look at him moving aside.
Alright, not the worst race so far. We're close to second and
they're trading, painting, flying along the back
first.
The other racers better watch out for those two.
Alright, Rocket Pop. Let me through. The one to my left is Candyland, the one to my right is Rocket Pop, the one in front of me is Green Jolly Rancher, and we got Hot Tamales, Banana Car, and Dolphin.
McQueen is driving, and of course, like the field is standing still.
We got the dude to my right, which I'm not going to mention his name, this is disgusting.
Pack your trunk, pal. You're going
I could have done that better. I should have really gone to the left. Really, this game is easy to win, you just stay to the left. If you stay to the left, you win, that's how it works. In that moment, I was too busy talking crap. Cheeto car. The one to my right is Cheeto car. The one in front of me. What do you remind me of? I don't know. It reminds me of like a gas station car. I don't know. The colors are like gas station colors. Then we got Rotten Banana. We got Monster. Looks like a Monster can. That lime green. I don't know why. This is very random. It reminds me of in Counter-Strike. There's a line of skins called Eco. They're red and red. Or white and green. So I'm going to name you the Eco car. Recycle car. Dark green. What are you? I don't know, man. Melon car. Almond Joy car. Alright, I'm having way too much fun with this. Let's just focus on the race here. We've got 1 second lead, which is good. Not the greatest, but it's good. Yeah, and as long as you just stay on the left, it's really hard to lose.
There goes Lightning McQueen, slipping through the pack.
It's just calculation, right? The farther left you are, the less track you have to run. So, it's easy as that. With these turns, you just want to try to get someone in the side. Keep your boost going. Other than that, I wonder if we'll even have to pit here. Maybe we'll pit. Maybe towards the later rounds we'll pit. In case we do something dumb, maybe.
Here comes Lightning McQueen. Just look at him moving aside.
Yup. Aw, come on, man. Eco, get out of my way.
Is there any stopping Lightning McQueen?
Probably. Get out of my way, banana car. You too, Almond Joy. I'm trying to get to Red Hot Tamale over there. Woo! Alright, that brighter red one's Gatorade car. That orange and black in front of you reminds me of like the construction, like the caterpillar equipment. So you're gonna be construction car. Ooh, yellow and blue. Did I already name you? I don't think I named you yet. You remind me of like Michigan colors, like, well, that, no surprise, I'm from Michigan, so that reminds me of like Michigan University. Water car. He's wet. Come on. Ooh. Let me through Monster Car. Yes. We should probably pit stop here. Alright, come on, Guido. We're gonna have the best pit stop of all time. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Oof. Next one. Oh yeah, this is gonna be good. R1. Bang, 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 bang. Easy. No, why do you torture me with this minigame? Why do you torture me with this minigame? This is such a torture minigame. Why did you do it with this one? Alright. Well, we couldn't do the last race without absolutely screwing up the pit stop, you know. Okay, we're gonna lose time on this. We might actually... I wonder if we can lose a race off of a bad pit stop. We certainly can. Alright. Alright, well, we gotta catch up now. Now, I don't think that'll be the hardest thing. We got really 4 laps to do it. But this is pretty bad. That was a bad pit stop. But, hey, everyone always loves a comeback story, right? So, even with a bad pit stop, we can win this. That'd be a pretty cool comeback story. I say that, and it's definitely going to be a comeback story. It didn't even take us one round to do it. Well, let's go a little wider here, huh?
McQueen passes another. You know he always runs well at this track.
Oh, yeah. Can we even go first person? Ooh, this is kind of cool. I feel like I'm going to like mess it up by doing this, but I'm just going to do it.
You never know where lightning will strike.
Ooh, this is kind of cool.
McQueen. Just look at him moving aside.
All right, we haven't screwed it up so far, although we almost did. All right, lap leader, here we go. Get out of my way, Jolly Rancher. Ooh.
There's another one. McQueen's passing through the field like he's racing against golf carts.
Oh, yeah. Alright, Candyland, banana car. Back to Molly.
He's definitely proven he's not a rookie anymore.
Nope, never was, bud. Never was. Alright, I almost threw away my lead there. Alright, I'm going back. I don't feel like throwing this race right now. That was cool, but no throw, no throw. Woo! Alright, we need to get ahead of this guy. Caterpillar car. There we go.
Just look at his determination.
Ooh, here we go. Alright, Eco, let me through. Final lap. Alright, we got almost a 5 second lead. What in the world is happening to number one? They're all falling. What, did y'all just break on me? What in the world? I feel like this is how you know the game is made for children. Because on right before the last round, they just make all of the good cars like basically suck. So it basically guarantees you a win. There's no reason all of a sudden they all should have just given me like another 5 second lead when I'm already so far ahead. But I'll take them. Well, the game is making them stand still. Alright, who? So it's me and then Suregrip, Hollister, Lee. Dude, why are they making me do like a rerun with Chick Hicks when he's getting fifth? He's not even close to the top. I'm like 20 seconds ahead of him. Alright, so we got 10 out of 10 on this event. Total for the entire game is 178 out of 250. With 188,000 points here so far. Now, we could gather up the rest of those trophies by basically doing, I think, Tomator stuff, the Doc stuff. I definitely won't be doing that today. There is a chance that I go back and try to 100% the game, but it definitely won't be today. Champion. Where's my Dynaco colors, huh? I feel like it when we go to the paint shop, we should be able to get Dynaco colors now. If we don't, that'd be a travesty. I want Dynaco colors. I want that disgusting light blue.
You be careful out there, son.
Ah, come on, Doc. I'm a veteran of the road now. A seasoned traveler.
You still don't have headlights.
Don't you worry, Doc. I'll take care of it.
And if you get stuck again?
I'm not gonna get stuck.
Well, if you do, you know I'll be there to help you out.
Thanks, Mater.
So, where are we going anyway?
I don't know. Wherever the road takes us, I guess. It's a pretty big country.
That's it. That's how we end the game. We just drive into the distance, not knowing where we're going. I mean, fair. A little poetic ending there. Poetic of what? Who knows? I'm not very creative. Alright. There's the game. Finished in one sitting at a total of 4 hours and 47 minutes. So we finished under that 5-hour mark. So that's good. Alright. Review time as usual with every game that I finish. Good game. Lots of fun. Yeah, it's short too. 5 hours basically. The driving is fun. The maps themselves, most of them are pretty cool. Really, I just hate the ones near the tail fin. They've got a lot of, like, you know, kind of windy ones. The game isn't that hard, I'll give you that. The only thing that I'll say is actually hard is the sheriff's stuff, where like, you gotta pull people over. Those ones are real hard. I don't know why. Well, I do know why, because they're fast and they move sporadically, and you have to stay like this behind them. So those ones are hard. The big tracks are not that hard, so they're even almost like a breeze compared to the rest of the game because they're just circles, right? So the game's not hard. Story-wise, there's no story here, guys. We're just winning the Piston Cup, right? So no phenomenal story out of this one. The graphics are cool. I experienced a few bugs here and there. You know, I fell through the map once or twice. I guess the only annoying part is, like, no quick travel, which, PS2 game, I know, But, like, getting over there to, like, a lot of the tail fin, like, a hotel all the way in the back, man, it's like a 15-minute drive all the way over there. It is slightly annoying having to drive all the way there. I like the game, though. If you're a fan of the Cars franchise, you have to play this game. It's just, it's good. It doesn't really add anything to the story, but it's just a good game. I guess the biggest thing I'll give it is the music I really like. The music just hits in the right place for me, that Elvis type music along with a lot of like the old country music, and the main song, you know, we bopped to it quite a few times. I love the music in this game. I don't know how much time they spent on it, but whatever they did it right. I love the music. So overall, I would play it, man. If you're a fan of the Cars franchise, play it. It's a good game. Very annoying. Some of the longer drives are very annoying. Some inconsistencies here. I think by far the most, I would say, annoying thing, but it's definitely good for children or people who suck. The game gives you a lot of leads and like helps you out a lot. That's how you can kind of tell it's almost a children's game in the sense that they don't want the kids to lose even if they suck. So like, you saw in the last couple of races, there was sometimes where I flipped over, literally got 15 seconds behind, and the game was just like, yup, we'll just push you all the way in front, and just instant 7-second lead. It's like, what? I should be punished. I messed up. I should lose. I shouldn't, you know, win here, but the game just gives it to you. So that's slightly annoying for people like me who I just want to feel like I won it fairly and that I did good. But you can almost just do bad and still just win anyway. As far as my own performance, I did pretty bad at most of those races. Now, saying that, we got first place on every single race that we took. And we really only lost, I think, 2 races out of this entire game in 5 hours. We only lost 2 races that we had to actually like restart. But again, that's even surprising, losing 2 races, considering the game. You lose and it just, here you go. Pretty first place, just for you. At the beginning of the game, it does ask you if you want full mode or kids mode. I don't know what the difference is, because this one basically treated me as a kid, even though it was full mode. I don't know, but it's a fun game either way. Like I said, I'm a pretty big mega fan of the Cars franchise. It's definitely like my favorite Pixar movie for sure. I would almost go as far to say it's my favorite animated movie. And dare I say it might be like my favorite movie of all time, but that's a little far. You know, favorite movie of all time, but I like Cars quite a bit. So something like this is fairly enjoyable, you know. Seeing all the people in 3D, you know, Flo and Sally and Tow Mater and the Doc, the Sheriff. Except Chick, screw Chick. So it's pretty enjoyable seeing all of them move around and talk a little bit outside of the movies. You know, you get a little bit of that, open free roam, you know. In a movie, you see them, but you can't change anything about the movie. But in this, you know, you can talk to them, hit them, smack them about, race them. So it's pretty cool. But I know movie adaptation video games, there we go. That's why most of us play them, right? We want to see the characters that were on screen, you know, to play with them a little bit, you know. These credits are like, by the way, guys, I don't usually talk as much, but these credits are just going on forever, and I'm trying to fill in the space. Dog, come on, man. Oh, there we go.
Ooh, I almost forgot. Did you pack your trophy?
Nah.
Where is it?
Don't worry. It's in a good place.
Is it with Doc? Nice. You got his 3 Piston Cups. We're adding on to it. 51, 52, 53 champion. Along with what year is this? 2006, bro. We're in 2023, dog. What? 2006 champion. Cool. We added our Piston Cup over to his 3 Piston Cups. God, I love that scene. That's like, actually, I've annoyed my wife quite a few times. We're like, 3 Piston Cups? I don't know why that specific line is just so funny to me. I love it. Just the way he says three piston cups.
We got a race coming up.
Ayo. Alright, so... the game is technically done. I'm done with the game. Now, of course, there are more trophies for me to collect. I think, as far as the missions go, I have one... I have 100% of all the missions, except... So we got Luigi... Luigi. So it's just, so the postcard, trap, tractor, Luigi, and then the sheriff. Those are the four things that I'm still, that I have to get done. And if I get those things done, I will 100% the game. But now, look at this. Ramones, okay. Lizzie's postcards, this shouldn't take a crazy long time, but they're just gonna be... this I could do, right? Now, where is it? Nothing on this one. Here's my big issue. This sheriff, these races for the sheriff are very, very hard. This is really the thing that I'm not looking forward to. Luigi's is probably going to be the easiest out of all of them. Not really worried about Luigi. And then... the tractor tipping is also, I'm not really that worried about. They shouldn't be that hard. But either way, we're not doing them tonight. I guess the last thing we'll do, we'll give ourselves the small treat of, since we now have finished the game, we'll do the one thing that I didn't want to do throughout the game, and that's change my body art. Now.
Attention is a good thing.
And you know what?
You're going to get a lot of it with that on.
We won't switch it up too badly either. You know what? We're going to go ahead and go with... the same color is just with a little bit of a different paint here. This signifies that we are done with the game. You know, I wanted standard Lightning McQueen for the entire game. But now that we're done, you know, we get a little extra. Now, here's the other thing that I'm very curious of. Is there Cars PS2 game cheat codes? So, if we go to the main menu, we can do a couple of things here. Let's go back to the cheat codes. All movies, all paint jobs, all races, all mini. Okay. Alright, so let's go over to options. Where's passcode? Records, credits, cheat codes. Yeah, that's the one I'm looking for. So if we go over here. How do we type in things? Oh, okay. Oh, no. Okay. So we gotta go. So. Okay. If we just go over here. Yay. Cars. And if we do that, we'll be able to unlock all of the cars. Okay. All concept art. Go and do that. What is that, a zero? Or an O? Concept. You do three. P. Okay, so real quickly, let's get back into the game here. Alright, there we go. Let's go back into story mode. Now we should have all the cars and all the paint jobs, which is pretty sick. Alright, Ramon's body of ours. Let's go in here and let's see what we got. Let's see what we can play with here.
Well, I designed that for this other cat, but...
Ooh, look at that. Got the Dinoco. I just talking about me wanting Dinoco.
You know, I don't even remember what you looked like before you came in here.
Okay.
And when you leave here, everybody's going to be all, look at that car, man. Yeah, one of my biggest sellers. Hey, you should go cruising.
I think we're doing Dinoco.
You know, right after you leave the shop, man, you know, show it off.
Can we switch, like, actual cars?
You know, not many cars can pull that off, but hey, that's all.
Now, how do we actually switch cars? That's my question. Yeah, so if I go to... maybe if I go to arcade, and I can just do, like, a Piston Cup race. Let's do Speedy South. Rookie. I think from here, Okay, so let's see. We got Lightning, Daryl, Doc, King, Chick, Lightning. Okay. Oh. And we got paint jobs for all of them?
What's styling this year?
Oh, that's pretty cool.
It's just one coat of paint, man.
So now, question. Do we have different ones for different places? So let's just do the road races, right? So now, if I go here, I think I'll have different cars. Yeah, Mater, Sally, Doc, Ramon, Flo, Sheriff, Wingo.
Yeah, one of my biggest sellers.
Okay. Let's take a look at some of these paints. Okay, Sally's got different colors. Hudson.
Oh, yeah, that works.
Wait, Ramon's should be pretty cool.
Attention is a good thing.
Flo, ooh! That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah, Sheriff. That's a good one. Hey, this is what's styling this year.
Alrighty, so now that we got all the cars, all the colors, I don't really have time to do anything with them right now. But yeah, I might try to finish the rest of the game. We'll see. To 100% it, I'll definitely need a couple more hours. We'll see. But thanks for watching.